Hello students, I welcome to all of you to this session of fleet, refrigeration and air conditioning. Dear students, I am Dhiraj Mondal, assistant professor, JS College of Engineering, Department of Mechanical Engineering, Kollani, Nodia. This is my email ID, you can see. You can submit all the assignment here and my phone number in case if you want to join JS College of Engineering. So most welcome to Department of Mechanical Engineering. Admission 2020 is open. It is going on right now. So in case of any query, you can contact here or you can contact me also. The Department of you know that JS College of Engineering is your you can see the rank according to the India Today rank 2020, and Department of Mechanical Engineering, it is the NBA accredited call department. Okay, so and also NAC, AICT, NIRF rank. Okay, WBUT, UGC approval college. So most welcome. If you want to join here, you can contact this number. Okay, this is the contact number of our HOD. So any kind of query, you can contact here also. Dear students, you know that last few classes I have taken vapor refrigeration reference system lecture, and you last class what we have seen the maximum COP of a VARS, that is your vapor refrigeration reference system. Also we have seen that your comparison between VCRS and VARS also we have seen. So today we'll be discussing about the domestic Electrolux refrigerator. This domestic Electrolux refrigerator is also called Mountain's Platin system or three fluid system. That means it is one kind of aqua ammonia refrigeration system. How it is working? So let us discuss. So you have seen this. This is your COP maximum is equal to TE by TC minus TE into TG by minus TA by TG in case of absorber. And this is the, you can see, this is the formula. And ultimately COP max is equal to Carnot COP into Carnot heat engine. Okay, so the efficiency of the Carnot cycle. Okay, so this was discussed last class. Today we will be discussing about the domestic Electrolux refrigerator. Okay, so in this diagram you can see the total you can see evaporator, absorber, water separator, condenser and generator. It is used here. So the domestic absorption type refrigerator was developed from an invention by Karl Munters. Okay, so the name of the scientist is Karl Munters and Balthazar von Platen. Okay, Balthazar von Platen. So according to that is why this system is called Munters Munter Platen system. By the name of the scientist, it is named Munters Platen system. So remember, the Munters Platen system is called domestic Electrolux refrigeration system. This type of refrigerator is also called three fluid absorption system. Three fluid, basically why the name is given three fluid absorption system? Three fluid, three fluids used in the in this system are ammonia, hydrogen, water. Ammonia, hydrogen and water are used here. That is why it is also called three fluid system. Okay, so the ammonia is basically used as a refrigerant. Remember, it is asked in MCQ question. That means in case of domestic Electrolux refrigerator, ammonia is used as absorbent or refrigerant. Okay, so the ammonia NH3 is used as a refrigerant because it possesses most of the desirable properties. You know that properties of the refrigerant. Okay, we will be discussing afterward. So the most of the desirable properties of ammonia is basically, that is why it is used as refrigerant. क्लियर। दो इट इज़ टॉक्सिक एंड नॉट अदरवाइज प्रेफर्ड इन डोमेस्टिक अप्लायंस, इट इज़ वेरी सेफ इन दिस सिस्टम ड्यू टू एब्सेंस ऑफ एनी मूविंग पार्ट इन द सिस्टम एंड देयरफॉर देयर इज द लीस्ट चांस ऑफ एनी लीकेज। ओके, सो बेसिकली दिस एमोनिया, इफ आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस एमोनिया, देन इट इज लिटिल बिट टॉक्सिक यू नो, बट एंड नॉट अदरवाइज, दैट मीन्स बेसिकली द डोमेस्टिक अप्लायंस, इन केस ऑफ द डोमेस्टिक अप्लायंस बेसिकली इट इज वी नो दैट इट इज टॉक्सिक एंड नॉट अदरवाइज प्रेफर्ड इन द डोमेस्टिक अप्लायंस, इट इज़ वेरी सेफ एंड इन दिस सिस्टम ड्यू टू द एब्सेंस ऑफ द ऑफ एनी मूविंग पार्ट, यू नो दैट देयर इज नॉट एनी काइंड ऑफ मूविंग पार्ट इन केस ऑफ दिस, इन केस ऑफ दिस थ्री फ्लूइड सिस्टम। व्हाट हैपेंड हियर, फ्रॉम द इवेपोरेटर द एमोनिया इज बेसिकली वेपराइज एंड विद एंड इट इज कमिंग टू द एब्जॉर्बर एंड द विद द H2 mixer, इट इज एब्जॉर्बिंग हियर एंड द स्ट्रॉन्ग सोल्यूशन इज कमिंग टू द जेनरेटर, फ्रॉम द जेनरेटर टू द वाटर सेपरेटर। ओके, एंड वीक सोल्यूशन इज कमिंग बैक टू द एब्जॉर्बर एंड फ्रॉम द एब्जॉर्बर यू कैन सी एंड अगेन वॉट हैपेंड, फ्रॉम द वाटर NH3 वेपर इज कमिंग टू द कॉन्डेंसर, देन कॉन्डेंसर टू द एवेपोरेटर अगेन एंड द H2 गैस, इट इज बेसिकली यूज टू used in the mixer of H2 gas. This H2 gas is to is basically circulating between evaporator and absorber. Okay, so it is very safe in basically this ammonia, it is very safe in the system due to the absence of any moving part, as there is not any kind of moving part in the system and therefore there is a least chance of any leakage. Okay, there is not any kind of moving part, that is why it is there, we can say that there is a least chance of the leakage. And so what I have seen, the ammonia is used as a refrigerant. Now if I am talking about the hydrogen, then hydrogen being the lightest gas, you know that it is very light and is used to increase the rate of evaporation. Why? The rate of evaporation should have been increased by the help of this hydrogen. The lighter the gas, the faster the evaporation, you know. If the gas is lighter, then evaporation will be faster. So, it is basically used to increase the rate of evaporation of the liquid ammonia passing through the evaporator. Whatever the liquid ammonia, you can see this is the in evaporator, the ammonia mixture and ammonia and hydrogen mixture will be there. Now it is the hydrogen, why it is used, because it is basically changing the rate of the evaporation. Okay, that means it is increasing the rate of the evaporation of the liquid ammonia passing through the evaporator. The hydrogen is also non-corrosive and insoluble in water. So I can say that it is non-corrosive and insoluble in water. This is used in the low pressure side of the system. So what happened? This hydrogen mixture is the rate of the evaporation is maximizing by the help of this hydrogen. And when it is, this mixer is coming here, this hydrogen gas is again taking some heat from the liquid ammonia, and it is the absorber here, the liquid ammonia is there with the water, and this strong solution is coming to the generator. So hydrogen gas is moving back to the evaporator again, and in the evaporator again what happened, the ammonia is vaporized and that particular ammonia and hydrogen is mixing together and it is changing or it is increasing the rate of evaporation. Okay, so this is the function of the hydrogen gas and it is basically used in the lower pressure region. Okay, and what is the function of the water? Water is used as solvent You know the solution, in the solution solvent is there, dhrobon or drabbo, you know that the solvent and solute, you know that solvent is basically, in the solution there is a part, one is solvent, dhrobon or drabbo, okay. So basically the water is used as a solvent because it has the ability to absorb ammonia readily. That means it can easily absorb ammonia, okay. That is why the water is used as a solvent, clear. So, or you can say that absorber is your water. So in case of three fluid system or Montrose Platen system or aqua ammonia refrigerant system or domestic Electrolux refrigerant system, we can say that water is used as absorbent and ammonia is your refrigerant, okay. So what is the principal working of the electrolytic? So you can see in this figure, is in this diagram, it is a domestic refrigerator and is the best known absorption type of refrigerator. Here the pump is dispensed with, okay. Then we are not using any kind of pump here. A small energy supply is by means of the heater, which may be electric or gas, okay. So we are not using pump here, just gravity, by the help of gravity separation this phenomena is occurring, okay. So what is the principle work? We can say that the principle involve mix use of the properties of gas vapors. If a liquid is exposed to an inert atmosphere, it will evaporate until the atmosphere is saturated with the vapor of the liquid, okay. This evaporation requires heat, which is taken from the surrounding, in which the evaporation takes place. A cooling effect is thus produced, okay. And the partial pressure of the refrigerant vapor must be low in the evaporator and higher in the condenser. The total pressure throughout the circuit must be constant so that the only movement of the working fluid by the convection current, the partial pressure of the ammonia is kept low in the requisite parts of the circuit by centralizing hydrogen in these parts, okay. So these are the principle by the help of which we can say that this electrolyzed refrigerant system operating. Now if I want to say that how it is operating, what is the working principle, how it is working, the ammonia liquid, you can see this is the evaporator. Here the ammonia liquid leaving the condenser, you can see this is the condenser. Now the ammonia liquid is leaving the condenser, enters the evaporator. This is the evaporator. Here it is, the ammonia liquid is entering and evaporates into the hydrogen, okay. What happened? And evaporates into the hydrogen, because in the evaporator the hydrogen gas is there, which is circulating between absorber and evaporator. So the ammonia basically, the ammonia and hydrogen, when it is mixing together, okay. So the evaporator when the ammonia is entering into the evaporator, and the evaporator into the hydrogen at the low temperature corresponding to its low partial pressure, the mixture of ammonia and hydrogen passes to the absorber. This is the absorber, and the mixture of ammonia and hydrogen passes to the absorber into which is also admitted water from the separator. Again, I am telling you, the evaporator, when it is entering into the evaporator, and the hydrogen and ammonia is mixture is coming here, and hydrogen is basically changing, increasing the rate of evaporation. So what happened? And after that, the liquid ammonia is here and hydrogen gas is coming back to the evaporator again. Now the water and ammonia is mixing and this is the solution, strong solution, which is coming to the generator. Okay, the absorber, so basically the water absorbs the ammonia, the water absorbs the ammonia and the hydrogen return to the evaporator, you can see in the figure. In the absorber, the ammonia therefore passes from the ammonia circuit into water circuit as ammonia in the water solution. Okay, so in the absorber, what happened? In the absorber, the ammonia passes from the ammonia circuit into water circuit as ammonia into water solution, and the strong solution passes to the generator where it is heated and the vapor given off rises to the separator. So from the generator some heat is added, heat is given, and the slow solution is coming to the water separator. Here water is separated and the strong solution is coming to the condenser, and a strong solution of NH3 vapor is coming to the condenser, and the weak solution is coming back to the absorber. Okay, so it is told the water with the vapor is separated out and the weak solution of ammonia is passed back to the absorber, thus completing the water circuit. That means the water circuit is completing right now from absorber, generator and the water separator. These are the circuit of water, water circuit. Water is flowing throughout this path. Okay, the ammonia vapor rises from the separator to the condenser where it is condensed and then return to the evaporator. So in the condenser, the high-rich ammonia, it is condensed and it is coming to the evaporator. Okay, the actual plan includes refinement and practical modification. Okay, there are some points which you have to remember, that to complete the cycle and complete cycle is carried out entirely by gravity flow of the refrigerant. So already I have told you that by the help of gravity separation, gravity flow, the complete cycle is carrying on. Okay, so that we are not using any kind of pump here. Okay, and the hydrogen gas circulates only from the absorber to the evaporator and come back to the evaporator again. Okay, next point, with the type of the machine efficiency is not important since the energy input is small. We are not using very small amount of energy is given, so efficiency or the COP is very very less. Okay, and it has not been used for industrial application as the COP of the system is very low. So we are not using in the industry because the COP whatever we are getting, that is very low. Okay, so these are the points which you have to remember. Now the role of hydrogen, already have told you little bit, but even though we have to know that what is the role of hydrogen. So basically by the presence of the hydrogen, it is possible to maintain uniform total pressure. So the if you want to maintain the uniform total pressure, then the hydrogen is very very important part. Okay, hydrogen is basically playing an important part. Okay, throughout the system, if you want to maintain the pressure, and at the same time permit the refrigerant to evaporate at low temperature in the evaporator corresponding to the partial pressure. So, and it is also accelerate the evaporation rate, clear. Thus the condenser and evaporator pressure of the refrigerant are maintained as, okay. So that is why we will see that the condenser and evaporation pressure is maintained, clear. Now next two point we have to remember, that in the condenser only ammonia is present. Okay, so only ammonia is present in the condenser. In the evaporator, ammonia and hydrogen present. In the absorber, ammonia, hydrogen, oxygen present. In the generator, ammonia in the absorber, ammonia, hydrogen and water present. In the generator, ammonia and water present. okay, and in the water separator, ammonia and water present. So this is very very important. Okay, so in the what I have told, in the condenser only ammonia is present. So it can be asked in the MCQ question that in the condenser what is present in three fluid system. So only ammonia. Okay, and the total pressure is the condensing pressure. In the evaporator, hydrogen and ammonia are present. Already I have told you. Present, and their relative masses are adjusted such that the partial pressure of ammonia is required evaporator pressure. Okay, so thus these are achieved without the use of the pump or valves. We are not using any kind of pump or valves here. Now let us discuss about the advantage and disadvantage of Electrolux refrigerator over conventional refrigerator. Okay, so what are the advantages? No pump or compressor is required here. You can see for the entire cycle there is not any kind of pump or compressor. Then number two, we can say no mechanical troubles, maintenance cost is low because there is not any kind of moving part, so that is why the mechanical travel is not there. Maintenance cost is low. No lubrication problem, no wear and tear. Okay, so we will not see any kind of lubrication and wear and tear because there is not any kind of moving part. Okay, next is your completely leak proof. Okay, why? Because it is basically flowing throughout the pipe and the tank, and on there is not any kind of moving part, so that we can say it is your completely leak proof. Noiseless, very very important. Noiseless is that means as it is noiseless. Why it is noiseless? Because there is not any kind of moving part. So, and next point is no chance of pressure unbalance and no need of valve. So basically hydrogen gas is basically controlling or maintaining this uniform total pressure. Okay, and point number seven, system may be designed to use any available source of thermal energy. Okay, the system may be designed to use any available source of thermal energy process steam exhaust from the engine or turbine solar energy. So you can avail by the help of this energy you can operate the system also. Okay, and easy control, simply by controlling heat input you can control it this system. Okay, next point number disadvantage, if I want to say that, then we can say that more complicated in construction and working, because you know that the process of separation, gravity separation is needed. There is not any kind of pump, so how it is moving, and this is very very slow process, isn't it? COP is very low, so see, very slow process. So the design perspective, the design is very complicated. COP is very low. The major disadvantage of this type of refrigerator is that if it is spoiled once, it cannot be repaired and has to be replaced fully. That means once it got damaged, then it should have been replaced, but it cannot be repaired. Okay, so this is the major problem, and which is a matter of worry. So these are the points which we need to know about the Electrolux refrigerator. So I hope it is clear. And again, I am telling you how it is operating in the evaporator. The ammonia vapor, it with the mixing by mixing of H2 mixture, the rate of evaporation is increasing, and it is coming to the absorber. In the absorber, the hydrogen gas is taking latent heat, and basically what happened, the water is absorbed and one kind of absorbent. So water and ammonia is mixing together, and the ammonia is again turns into liquid, and the हाइड्रोजन गैस इज बेसिकली कमिंग बैक टू द इवापोरेटर. नाउ फ्रॉम द एब्जॉर्बर द एमोनिया एंड वाटर इज एज ए स्ट्रॉन्ग सोल्यूशन, इट इज एंटरिंग इन टू द जेनरेटर एंड फ्रॉम द जेनरेटर इट इज कमिंग टू द NH3 वाटर सेपरेटर. एंड एज द नेम सजेस्ट वाटर सेपरेटर, देन वी कैन से दैट वाटर इज सेपरेटेड एंड द स्ट्रॉन्ग सोल्यूशन स्ट्रॉन्ग NH3 वेपर इट इज कमिंग टू द कॉन्डेंसर अगेन. And from the condenser, in the condenser only vapor NH3 we will see. Okay, in the condenser it is condensed and heat content is rejected to the surrounding. And the liquid NH3 at the outlet of the condenser, the liquid NH3 is available. Now it is coming to the evaporator again. Then from the evaporator with the help of the hydrogen mixture, hydrogen gas, it is coming to the absorber again. So this is how the process is going on, and we are not using in the industry or because as it is very very low COP and it is given very very low COP, more complicated design, and major disadvantage is the once it is damaged then you have to replace the full part. Okay, you cannot repair it. Okay, so this is the main important thing that you need to know. Okay, now we will discuss the desirable properties of an ideal refrigerant. Okay, there are so many properties. The mainly there are thermodynamics properties like low boiling point. Okay, so low boiling point required for an ideal refrigerant, low freezing point. Okay, then positive pressure is in evaporator and condenser. Okay, but not very high. Okay, positive pressure in evaporator and condenser needed, and high saturation temperature is needed. The high latent heat of vaporization is needed. These are the thermodynamic properties. So these are the properties which are needed. If I am talking about the chemical properties, then non-toxicity means your it should not be toxic. And it should be non-inflammable or non-explosive. Okay, point number 3, non-corrosiveness. There should not be any kind of corrosiveness. Corrosive resistance should be there. Chemical stability in reacting. And number 5 is your no effect on the quality of stored food and other product like flour with the other material like fruits, fabric, okay, like this. Okay, and the non-irritating and odorless property should be there. These are the chemical properties. If I'm talking about the physical properties, then low specific volume of vapor required, low specific heat required, high thermal conductivity required, low viscosity required, and high electrical insulation. Why? Because we will be discussing it afterward. And other properties, in case of other property, if I would like to mention that ease of leakage location. Okay, there should be ease of leakage location means your if there is any kind of leakage, then easily it can be found. Okay, next point number 2, availability at and low cost. The refrigerant should be available in the market and cost should be low. And number 3 is your ease of handling. It should be handled very easily. After that, I can say the high COP should be required. That means coefficient of performance should be high. And low power consumption per ton of refrigeration. Very, very important, because based on that, the high COP is basically depending upon. So low power consumption per ton of refrigeration is required, and low pressure ratio and pressure difference should be there. Okay, so these are the points which is very very important. These are the desirable properties. So next class we will be discussing what are those in details, that properties, and how we can calculate, the mathematical expression, next class we will be discussing about the nomenclature of the designation of the refrigerant. Okay, so all this it will be discussed, and also lithium bromide refrigerant system will be discussed. So I hope it is clear, and today up to this, next class we will be discussing all this, and you have to submit the assignment what I have discussed it, then you solve it in your home, it is your homework, and submit the assignment in this given mail, and you can call me any kind of query related to admission is open for 2020. Most welcome to Joyous College of Engineering and Department of Mechanical Engineering. You know that NBA Tier 1 accredited college, so you can join and you can contact here if you want to join JIS College of Engineering. Today up to this, thank you for listening. Jai.